PathPilot quick tips. Wanted to show you some new features in PathPilot 2.2.2 or newer. Right away, we wanted to start by showcasing the new support for the 1100 M Plus and the 770 M Plus. So in the newer config chooser, you can see there's actually two new choices. And these are the M models that have the servo upgrades for faster rapids installed. So this is an 1100 M Plus, so we're gonna pick that and launch PathPilot and show you the rest of the video. So here we are in PathPilot 2.2.2. We're on an 1100 M Plus and wanted to lead off by showing you some of the new features in the tool table. On the offsets tab, we have a 1000 tool table. Really handy, plenty of room, but can get kind of large if you leave gaps between tool numbering. Sometimes it's kind of easy to, you know, start your drills at 100 or your end mills at 500 or something like that. So in this particular tool table, there is a number of gaps and it can lead a little bit to a lot of scrolling around. So I've got a program loaded here, and once you load a program, you'll notice a few things. One is that the tools that are used by the current program, the tool number is shaded a little darker. So that's one clue that these are used. But we also added a new combo box up here that you can drop down and say, hey, show me just the tools used by the current G-code file. And we collapse and pull out all the rows that aren't used. So it lets you zero in and focus on what are the tools that I need to have ready, prepped in the ATC or sitting in my holders for this job. You can also filter it with tools with descriptions. So, you know, the blank rows that you haven't filled in and done anything with, we basically remove all of those, and it lets you focus on just the tools and the tool numbers that you actually want to be able to see. So those are the new features on the filtering. We also powered up the search. We had a search capability before, but it was a little hidden and limited. Now there's a nice big search box at the top, and search has improved in a couple different ways. It's case insensitive, so you can search any mixed case, we'll find things. It searches across any of the columns for what you type in as well. So a good example is, I know I've got a 2mm drill in here somewhere. I don't know which one number it is, I forget. I can just type 2.0mm and boom, it's taken me to tool 160 because it's found the 2mm right in there. You can also search easily for things like, let me type in end mill. So it finds the first end mill, but I know I've got a lot of them and that's not the one I'm looking for. So if I want to search find next or find previous, the up arrows and down arrows pop you between those. The enter key also takes you forward. And then escape just starts your search back over again. So some really handy ways of just being able to zero in and manage your tool table a lot easier. The other big feature that we've added is the override sliders and now take you all the way up to 200%. So formerly we capped them at 150. When they start to get to be unusual values, we color them yellow for you just to alert you that these might be a little bit unusual. But 200% instead of 150 helps you dial in feeds and speeds on that. The other area that we did was enhance the context of the G-code. Here I've got a file loaded. As I start to run and stop and I'm dialing in, maybe this is the first time I've run this file. A lot of times you might be stopping prematurely at different spots as you're like, oh, you know, figuring things out. Formerly, whenever you clicked stop, we would always rewind the display and put the display back up at line one. And it kind of, you know, if you broke a tool in the middle or something, sometimes it's hard to understand, well, where did I leave off? Now, with 2.2.2 or newer, when you run a program, if I click stop, we just leave it exactly where it was. So I know, hey, I was just machining line 29, right? If you hit cycle start again, it does start over at line one, and we always show you which line that's going to be by showing you the green line. That's the start line. But we now don't clear those other indicators of where you left off or scroll. So kind of helpful. If you want the other behavior, if you just click the reset button, we always rewind it automatically for you. The other feature we added was reminding you when you're dealing with very large G-code files that for performance reasons, sometimes PathPilot by default limits the number of toolpath lines. The default, I think, is 100,000. And so in this program, you can tell when in the CAM program, I had 5 of these circles and I loaded it up and I'm confused because I only see 3. But now we remind you all the time by putting in the upper right here that the preview is limited. And the fastest way to now get rid of that limit and say, I don't care how many lines, I just want to see the whole file. So if on the G-code window, you can right click and say, load all preview lines. We also put that underneath the touch accessible menu for touchscreen users. So if I say load all preview lines, we go back to the file, we remove the limits, we load all the lines, and then you'll see 5 of these here. There's our 5 knobs, and the file preview warning is no longer visible. So hope you enjoy a couple of new features here in PathPilot 222, and check out more video tips up here and subscribe to the channel down here.